Hello friends, praise the Lord. Today we are going to see chapter 21 from the book of Genesis. So here it says that Sarah bore a son, Isaac, God's promise. Isaac at her old age. So again, we emphasize that nothing is impossible for God. Second, if God says, if he promises, he will definitely do it. We only have to wait. So finally, they got a child. So that was Isaac, and that was when Abraham was 100 years old. Okay, 100 years old, he is getting a son, and the promise came 25 years before, and he was waiting for 25 years for the promise to be fulfilled. So many a times we also need to wait, but let us be assured that definitely if God had said he will heal, if he has said that he will take care, definitely it will be done. Only thing, a set time, God has a time, and it has to happen in its own time. So that is one thing that we have to learn from this. And as usual, we saw the circumcision was done. That was the covenant that was made by God with his chosen people. So Isaac also was circumcised 8 days, which is equivalent to baptism, which I was telling. And then it is said that Isaac grew. And you know, Ishmael also was there, Hagar's son. And so Ishmael was elderly, or maybe by 10 years, 12 years elderly. So Sarah saw him playing with Ishmael. And somehow she did not like Isaac playing with Ishmael and getting all his habits, I don't know what. So she told Abraham that my son should not share the inheritance with the son of a slave. So I'm not happy with him playing with this boy Ishmael. So I want you to send her away. Though Abraham was distressed. So when he was, because it is of course his son, and it is not fair to send Hagar and Ishmael away. So, but still Sarah asked him to do. So what he did next was, he spoke to God. He asked God, tell me what should I do? This is what is happening in our family. There is a conflict. But God spoke back to Abraham and said, listen to Sarah now. Send Hagar and Ishmael away. I will take care of them. Don't worry, you send her. So once he received the confirmation from God, he took a decision. And then, so from here onwards, we can see that anything that Abraham is doing, he will always consult with God, and then only he will do. So therefore, he was blessed in every way. So he sent Hagar and Ishmael. And of course, Hagar was very disappointed with this thing. She traveled a lot in desert. The water that she brought was over, and she was really struggling. She kept the child in front of the child. She sat opposite to the child and started crying and thought to abandon the child and go away. So that cry God heard. Okay. And God said, don't be afraid, Hagar, and I will definitely make Ishmael a great nation. Don't worry about it. So that was the time Hagar listened to God's voice, and she saw a well of water. So wherever there is a well, which means there are some people who are staying over there, and it is a place for habitation. So she went there, gave water to the child, and settled there. So it is said that she settled there, and the son grew up, and she got him married, and the child became an expert bowman. Okay, so this is what is given in chapter 21. Also, we also find that at the same time, Abimelech, the king, we have told about Abimelech, king of Gerar, he met Abraham and said, see, whatever you do, I'm able to see that God is blessing you in every way. So therefore, he begged him not to deal falsely with him. See, now we can see that people who were against us, will always look at if God is with us, and when people see that God is blessing us and we are not worried about any circumstance that is happening around, God is giving us the strength, then they will be scared. So the king was scared, and he came and he said to Abraham, I know that God is with you, so please don't deal falsely with me. So we need to understand that if God is with us, we will be the majority, and we will be more powerful than the king himself. Okay. Then next is, next thing that we can see in chapter 21 is that, so when Abimelech came and met Abraham, Abraham sweared. He said, no, I'm not going to do anything with you. Don't worry about it. But I have one request. This well which I dug, see, one thing that we have to understand, those days when people were, you know, nomads, no, they were going from one place to the other, they used to dig wells and settle over there. So the well is actually a very important a part of habitation, as I was telling, where people will be living, and that means it is their own. So the first thing what they do is digging well. So Abraham, actually every time he was digging the well, the people of that country will come and close it. So which means that not allowing him to stay there. That is how it is. So Abraham used this opportunity to ask the king, said that here, this is the well I dug, but your people are coming and seizing it. So I want an agreement that this is mine only, that your people will not seize it. So this is mine and we will be settling over here. So Abimelech agreed, and then they made a pact, an agreement, that my people will not come and harm you. So that well became the well that was dug by Abraham, and that place was called as Beersheba. Beersheba, the place was called so. Then Abraham stayed there in the land of Philistines for many years. So this is how what is given in chapter 21. Okay, thank you. God bless.